he's German, and I think he's very possibly made by the strange German manufacturer who made the Gebrüder Süßengut bear, which is called the Peter bear. And he wasn't, not many of them were made because he was so grotesque looking, and the bear sort of growls at you and looks like this with these wooden eyes rolling like this. And actually, I think he's rather frightening for a child, don't you?
I don't know, we found him rather endearing. I think we like cats and... Wow.
Very Victorian thing, berry spoons. They were given a lot as gifts, usually cased in a nice velvet-lined case, and perhaps given either as a christening or a wedding gift. And the silver examples are very often Georgian ones that have been Victorianized. And this is indeed is 1794 London mark. That would have been a plain tablespoon originally.
Mm-hmm.
And then somebody, a silversmith, has chased it afterwards. In, say, 1860, that sort of period. I mean, it was really right through the middle part of the 19th century. And here's a teaspoon that's been embossed in the same way.
Oh, that's an ordinary teaspoon?
Mm-hmm.
The Japanese are so clever at these toys. I mean, they go on and on and on. I mean, he was made probably in the 50s, and he'll probably delight your great grandchildren and still be working. I think these are the toys to collect in the future. I really do.
Well, this little painting is by an artist called Emile Auguste Pinchart. Did you know that?
No, I did not.
Well, he's one of those artists who's very little known. I mean, he is known, he is recorded, but not a lot about him. I notice he's inscribed. Can you tell us something of the history?
Well, that is a picture of my wife's great aunt, done on the banks of Lake Como.
Yeah, so this is your wife's great aunt?
Yes.
Who is named Miss Allen?
Yes. Now, she is from the family of the... publishers, Allen and Unwin.
Oh, right.
Her great-great-grandfather started Allen and Unwin.
One hopes that, in a way, or one would like to think that it may be a charming little love note, although
yes.
She was probably quite young and he was about 50. He was born in 1842. He's French, in fact.
Oh,
but and a pupil of a very classical artist called Jerome. But here, he's not being Jerome-like at all. He's moved to Switzerland.
Yes.
He's being much more avant-garde for the time. He's, part of the modern movement, very much like Alfred Stevens, the Belgian, what we call today post-impressionists, what all the Scandinavians were doing and everything else. But I think this picture has such that extra touch of beauty and charm, romance.
Yes.
We'd all like to be standing on that pier.
Tell me, I've wondered for a long time, is it an oil or...?
The reason it's confusing is it's oil, but it's on card or paper. Oil takes on a certain quality when it's painted on paper, different quality. But I think it's absolutely beautiful, and it seems extraordinary, but I think one could buy a picture like this for, say, £3,000 or £4,000. Now, if Mr. Pinchart had a slightly different name, which was better known, we might be talking about £15,000. So it's not a very expensive picture.
No.